I've made a copy of ODB 49, and I'm calling this one ODB 50 Single Table ListBox. I'll go into Tables and select the Table Employees Original. On this table, we see that our department information and our group information is still all on a single table. Going into our forms, I'm going to make a copy of ODB 36 Employee Add Subform. Paste that. And give that the name. ODB 50 Single Table ListBox. I'm going to right-click on that and edit. I'm going to select the subform and delete that, as well as the picture and the logo. Now I'm going to click on the select arrow and move our buttons up to the top of the screen. Before we start anything else, I'm going to go into design mode and see if everything's working properly. We see that the department and the group are not showing up. Let's go back into edit mode. I'm going to open up our form navigator. Right click on the main form, open up properties, and in the data tab under content, we're pointing to the employees table. We want to point to the employees original table. And let's go back into design mode and make sure that's working okay. Now we see that the department is showing up as well as the group. Going back into edit mode. To make things easy, I'm going to make sure that my wizards is turned on. Right now it's off, and it's on when we've got the little outline around it. We see I've got everything selected because I see the green boxes around our outline. I'm going to click outside of that to deselect everything. Now I'm going to click on the list box. I'm coming down right next to our department text box, and I will place our new list box right there. Our list box pop-up opens up. We want to select the table that's going to hold the information in our list box. That's going to be our employee's original table. And the field we want to update is department. Clicking next. Now it's asking us what fields do we want to match up, as we saw in the previous videos, with two tables. Here we only have a single table, but the principle is the same. We want to match up the department field with the department field. And we'll look at this again in just a minute. I'll click Finish. Let's see how this looks in design view. Here we see the department is accounting in the text box. And in our list box as well, we see accounting, which is what we want to see. When I click the arrow, we see all the departments, but we see them multiple times. Actually, we see them 27 times, one for each record on the table. Let's go back into edit mode and fix that. I'll click on the control icon. Coming back up here to list content, we see select distinct department from table employees. Earlier in the video, I said we're going to look at this a little closer. Here's where we're looking at it. We've got the data field. This is the department on the employee table that is mapped up to the form. In our list content, this very first entry, or the zero entry, is what matches up to the data field. We saw that in previous tutorials. This second one is not really needed, but when we click down and look in the bound field, we're pointing to one. So if we change this to zero, now this second field is not needed. Let's delete that. And I also need to delete that comma right there. If I don't delete that comma, we will get an error. Now we're selecting distinct department from table employees. So the department is now matching up to the data field. And in our bound field, we're pointing to the zero entry, which is this very first one in our select. So this should work. Now we've got department accounting. We'll change this to IT, save, and it changes to IT. One other thing I wanted to point out here is when we click this dropdown, we see an empty line at the top. That is for a null value because we allow null values for the department. Let's save the form, close it, go into our tables, employees original, edit, and we're going to change the department from entry required from no to yes. Save. Yes, we want to save the changes. Going back into forms, opening up our single table list box. Now when I click this down arrow, we don't have the blank line there. So we cannot set it to null. We must set it to one of these values. So that's what that blank line was. And I will save our database.